गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. वी विल मूव टू नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इन CNS इज बेसल गैंग्लिया. सो बेसल गैंग्लिया इज वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट सबकॉर्टिकल रीजन ऑफ द ब्रेन. सबकॉर्टिकल मीन्स सपोज दिस इज द हेड और द ब्रेन. सो देर आर डिफरेंट न्यूक्लियर आर प्रेजेंट, आर रीजन्स आर प्रेजेंट. सो वी कॉल इट सब कॉर्टिकल रीजन. सो बेसल गैंग्लिया विच इज प्रेजेंट बिलो द सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स. सो इट इज कॉम्पोज्ड ऑफ मेनी न्यूक्लियाई. सो मेनली इट कॉम्पोज्ड ऑफ मेनी न्यूक्लियाई एंड लॉट्स ऑफ कनेक्शंस बिटवीन द बेसल गैंग्लिया एंड सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स. सो सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स इज द मेन रीजन for the because it contain both sensory and the motor system that will mainly the main function of the cerebral cortex. Because of the connection with the basal ganglia with the cerebral cortex, so definitely it will involve in the movements. So the nucleus, mainly it contain caudate nucleus, putamen, globus pallidus, substantia nigra and subthalamic nucleus. So these are the nucleus. So suppose this is the cerebral cortex. So this is the cerebral cortex. So below the cerebral cortex, okay, so there is a basal ganglia is present. So this is the basal ganglia. So in the basal ganglia, mainly made up of different types of nucleus, okay. So suppose like for example caudate nucleus, this is the globus pallidus, okay, substantia nigra, so this is substantia nigra and subthalamic nucleus, okay. So there are on both the side it is present. So this is the right and left part, okay. So in the middle this is the imaginary line if you put, so left side and right side, okay, all are two sets are present. So very important thing is here, there are two part. One is the basal ganglia and another one is cerebellum. So cerebellum I will tell in the next class. So from the skeletal from the motor cortex to do motor action through the pyramidal tract, the impulses will reach the skeletal muscle. So before it reach the skeletal muscle, so one of the information impulses go to basal ganglia and the cerebellum. So these two center will region, what it will do, it will correct the movement. So it has to take timings of the movement and accuracy of the movement they will regulate, okay. And if there is any correction is there, so basal ganglia will inhibit the motor cortex and it will prevent the further action of the skeletal muscle. For you people, the functions of the basal ganglia is important, okay. Functions of basal ganglia. So one is planning and programming of motor movement, okay. Planning, that means, so for example you are planning to do you are planning to take the book, okay. So the thought will arises in your head, in your mind, in your cortex, and that planning how to take the book, like the speed of the of taking the book or the timings, within 2 seconds you have to take, like that, okay. So and from where it is, the book is there, from there to there how many distance is there, so everything is a planning, okay. So planned by the basal ganglia. And programming, to take, programming means it has to take place correctly and smoothly, okay. So that is conversion of idea into an action. The second one is a cognitive control of motor movements, okay. A cognitive control, motor movement driven by thoughts. So whatever the thoughts it is coming, suppose you are want to do bat ball, cricket you want to play, so the thought will come to your mind. So that basal ganglia helpful for to that move, to achieve that movement. Then timing and scaling of motor movement. So time, so that is the rapidity, okay, and the intensity of the motor movement, so it will perform. So third one is execution of motor movements, okay. So it will prepare for your initiation and automatic execution of learned plan, automatic association movements and mannerism. So for example, for this when you are walking, okay, when you are walking, so you will swing your arm, right? So when you are walking, you will swing your arm. So that is automatic association movement. That's automatically your hand will move, okay, along with your leg. Leg movements is by pyramidal tract, but along with that, your hand is also moving. So that is because of initiated by basal ganglia, okay. Then mannerism, then emotional aspects, then helps in smooth progression of voluntary motor activity, okay, the smooth progression, the smooth action of the movement, it will help. So you will not grab the book, right? So you slowly will go and take the book. So that is a smooth action. Has got control over some reflex muscular activity, okay? So like urination or micturition reflex and all, it has control, and also control over the muscle tone. Forms an important constituent of extra pyramidal tract system. So what it will do, it will form a there is a pyramidal tract and extra pyramidal tract. Pyramidal tract, the impulses are coming from the motor cortex. Extra pyramidal tract, the impulses are coming from other regions. So it is also important constituent for to form a extra pyramidal tract. Okay, clear? So next, coming to the neurotransmitters, which is released by basal ganglia. So basal ganglia also it has a dopaminergic activity. That's an inhibitory neurotransmitters. Okay, inhibitory means it is stopping the action, like dopaminergic, GABAergic. Okay, then these things are not needed. Okay, so just remember, inhibitory, dopaminergic, and GABA. Excitatory is glutaminergic and cholinergic. Okay, these are the neurotransmitters released by basal ganglia. So that's complete the functions of basal ganglia. Okay, so in this heading only the functions of basal ganglia and one of the important clinical condition or disorders of basal ganglia, we call it as Parkinsonism or Parkinson disease. Okay, Parkinson disease. So this is also very important. In basal ganglia, there are different pathways is there. Okay, internal pathway is there. So one of the important pathway is nigrostriatal pathway. Okay, so from the substantia nigra, and there is a nigrostriatal pathway. So just remember, nigrostriatal pathway. Due to lesion of this nigrostriatal pathway, so mainly this pathway produces dopamine, is a neurotransmitter. Okay, dopamine is a neurotransmitter produced by nigrostriatal pathway. Due to lesion, you understood, right? So damage of nigrostriatal pathway, so that will not produce dopamine. Okay, so dopamine is a inhibitory neurotransmitter. So because of loss of dopamine in basal ganglia, so that will cause a disease called Parkinson disease. Okay, Parkinson disease. Next, coming to what are the features if the person is having Parkinson disease, and their dopamine is absent because of damage to nigrostriatal pathway. So it will affect mainly to motor system. Okay, so one is rigidity. Okay, so akinesia. So you just write the rigidity, akinesia, the name is enough. Okay, so rigidity is due to hypertonia. So due to loss of inhibitory action, so that will cause the increase in muscle tone, leads to hypertonia. Okay, so that will involve the flexor and extensor muscle. So that is enough. Next is akinesia, means or hypokinesia, slowness of the movement. Okay, slowness of the movement, we call it akinesia. So the movement become very slow. So if you want to take a book, so what will happen, the movement is very slowly, you will go and take, okay, like that. So due difficult to initiation of the movements are slow. Okay, and it will require high degree of concentration to initiate the movement. Okay, next is the poverty of the movement. Okay, So poverty of the movement due to absence of automatic associated movement, absence of emotional movements. So that is very important. The face is look like a mask, okay, like a statue like appearance, okay. There is no facial expression only. Then tremor. So tremor here, the resting tremor, okay. Resting tremor means tremor, you understood, right? Tremor means a shaking of your fingers, the fine movements. Okay. So what will happen here? So when you are not doing any work, okay. So that time the tremor come. If you are going to pick the box or any books and all. So that time the tremor is not there. So only when you are sitting or resting. So resting tremor. And gait, their walking style will be different, okay. So that is called fascinating gait. So the person will bend forward, okay, he will bend forward and going as to catch the center of gravity. So that means it looks like that, okay. The person will bend forward and he will going to looks like he is going to catch something, okay, or anything. The center of the gravity or gravity is going to catch like that it looks, okay. So these are the features. So one is a rigidity, akinesia, poverty of the movements, absence of emotional movements, and also facial expression is not there, the tremor, the resting tremor appear, and the gait or the fascinating gait are the symptoms of Parkinson's disease. Next come to treatment. So what we can do, we can give administration of L-DOPA. Okay, so dopamine we can give, so along with the carbidopa to prevent metabolism in liver. Are you just right? Administration of L-DOPA can be given. Okay, so these are about the basal ganglia. So basal ganglia, very important is functions of basal ganglia and Parkinson disease. Okay. So okay, I will continue with the next topic. Okay, the next topic, cerebellum.